Hello and welcome to HK's World of Music. It's great to be back. I've been away for a long, long time. I'm really sorry for that. For you new ones, this is a channel that reviews music, reacts to music videos, and generally, it's a music channel. I was away for about 6, 7, or 8 months because I burned out. I made a video every day, and it was really, really rough on me. And in the same time period as I made all these videos, just let me do this. No. In the same time frame I did all these videos, I got stressed and I got high blood pressure. I had to wear a heart monitor for work. And I was in real pissy shape. Since then, I've lost about 40 pounds. And I'm doing much better. I'm not gonna be making a video per day, but I'm gonna make videos. Just let me do this. Yeah. That's great, that's better. You can see me now. Yeah, anyway. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. You can do it in that corner. You just hit the little red button right here and you can subscribe. If you go to my channel, there's a link in the description. You can see all my other videos. I have reaction videos, reviews, just about everything you can imagine. So just watch those videos if you want to, if you want to be entertained, if you're wondering what kind of music this is all about. My channel is primarily gonna cover heavy metal and rock and roll and folk, American folk music. Which brings me to today's topic, which is the White Buffalo. The White Buffalo. And since I sort of stopped doing YouTube videos, I got to know this performer's music. I don't know him, his music, and I think it's really, really great. He was born in Oregon and raised in California. His stage name is the White Buffalo. His voice is a baritone with a really wide range. He has a lot of live stuff on YouTube at Guitar Center, amongst others. And it's just amazing what he does. When he plays the whistler, he whistles and sounds just like the studio. And if you look at modern day pop music and all that stuff, none of those people can do what he does. He's just an amazing performer. He plays his guitar and uses his voice, and that's all he needs. His new album that came out in 2017, it's a lot more plugged rather than unplugged. But it's still great. It's a great album. He's got great music. His first album came out in 2002 and it's called Hogtied Like a Rodeo. It's a really great album. You can listen to it on Spotify or YouTube or whatever. You do whatever you like. What made me find him was just searching for YouTube videos and I just stumbled across him. He had a song what's that show called with all the bikers and shit? It's called Sons of Anarchy. He had a song there called Come Join the Murder in season 7, I think. And I don't know. I think maybe it hurt him rather than make him more of a star. Because the I don't know how the popularity with Sons of Anarchy is in America, but here in Norway, it's, you know, if you watch it, you're kind of, yeah, we call it Harry, but you're kind of like outsider, and you know, you buy the vest that says Sons of Anarchy and you look kind of stupid. The one song that made me listen to him more and more and more and more, I've listened to this song about 1,000 times. It's called Wish It Was True. I've read some comments on YouTube, and there was this one guy, I don't know his name, he said that this song is so patriotic, it's so American. But I don't think so. If he had listened to the words or read the words or whatever, found the lyrics online, he would have seen that it's not patriotic. It's kind of against the government. It's about a guy that comes home from the war, don't know what war, and he says that when the governments used him in the military, they don't know who he is anymore. So I don't know what he meant by that comment, but he didn't listen. And you know, when you find an artist that he grows on you, you know, and then you just keep listening to him. He's like that. His voice can maybe be weird to some people when they listen to him, but when you find the right song, it's like everything just falls into place. And like I said, his voice is really amazing and his music is really amazing. It's just him and his guitar, except for a new album. And Wish It Was True is a great song. The Whistler, Come Join the Murder is great. Those are my top 3 songs with this performer. I hope he comes to Norway so that I can buy a ticket and watch him. Because I think that being in the same room as him and hearing his voice really live, I think that would just be amazing and send shivers down my spine and just be great. So yeah, that's my take on the White Buffalo. I hope he gets all the credit he deserves. I don't think he does in Norway anyway. I don't think anybody's ever listened to him in Norway, except maybe for me. Well, there are probably a couple of people. But anyway, I thought he deserved for me to make a comeback on YouTube. I think he made me come back to YouTube because I really had to put the word out there, if it isn't already out there, that he is a really great performer, and I hope he does well, because he's exactly what music needs. If you look at pop music today, they can't sing, they can't play anything, they just look pretty and that's it. They sell a lot of albums, but it's not really great music, is it? So I hope you listen to him. Remember the White Buffalo, and look for him on YouTube. He has a lot of great live stuff, a lot. And he can whistle too, if you listen to the Whistler. So I hope you have a nice day. I hope you subscribe. I hope you go to my channel, watch the other videos. Leave a comment, leave a thumbs up or not. If you don't like the video, leave a thumbs down. Tell me what I can do better. And I hope you have a great day, and I will see you once a week, not 7 times a week. This has been HK's World of Music, signing out.